So we will be discussing question answers of chapter packing. What happened? So we have discussed how many questions yesterday? Three questions are discussed. So let's continue with the third question. How did George and Harris react to this? Did Jerome like their reaction? Some students are not still serious in my class. They have started coming offline, but they are coming for fun and enjoyment. So, bachche, let's discuss question number third. How did George and Harris react to this? Did Jerome like their reaction? So, first, his suggestion was accepted or not? His suggestion was accepted. They agreed to it. His suggestion was agreed. Okay, and after that, what happened? What was the reaction of George? George spread himself. Okay, and where was he sitting? Easy chair. He sat on a easy chair. And what was the gesture of Harris? Yes. Yes, he cocked his leg. Okay, so you have to tell about both the reactions and how did they respond? What was their body language at that time? So George, he spread himself on an easy chair, and Harris, he cocked his legs on the table. And this reaction was liked by narrator or not? Jerome.
No.
Jerome did not like their reaction, and he was feeling very much annoyed. He was feeling irritated at such kind of gestures. So who is going to tell me this full-fledged answer? I'm going to appreciate, because in online, sometimes it is very difficult to recognize the student's capability. But in offline, your capabilities can be recognized very easily. These two, those who are sitting together, sit separate. Yogi and Laksh. Okay, Simran, you tell me.
When Jerome said that he took to the packing, he readily accepted his suggestion. George stepped himself over the easy chair and Harris crossed his leg on the table. Jerome was irritated by their action. He felt something was wrong and really weird. Actually, he had experienced this type of behavior before when he used to live with a man who used to read Jerome to all the work and also made him mad by some things he had liked. So when Jerome offered his help, because he didn't want to see other people sleeping, he got so surprised by how happy and relaxed his friends became. He came and sat down to the TV watching his own career.
Your answer quality is very good, but you have written did not wanted. With did not, we will be using first form. He did not want. Otherwise, superb. Yes, now next, Renuka, you tell me same answer. एक मिनट ओके सो बेसिकली यू हैव टू टेल अबाउट देयर बॉडी लैंग्वेज हाउ डिड दे रिएक्ट टू दैट सिचुएशन हाउ डिड दे रिस्पॉन्ड हाउ वर दे लाइंग सो रिलैक्स्ड and after that, after looking at both friends, when they were sitting like you can say kings, and what was the reaction of their friend? So he was feeling annoyed and he was feeling irritated to see their body language, to see their posture of sitting and behaving. Okay, clear this answer. What was Jerome's real intention when he offered to pack? So when it means Jerome was given this task, what was his real intention? Yes, he wanted to behave like a boss. He wanted to supervise other two friends. He wanted to sit relaxed. Okay, so he wanted that under his guidance others should work. So such kind of intention he was having, that he wanted to behave like a boss. He wanted to sit and supervise. He wanted to sit relaxed. He wanted to give them instruction. So such kind of intention he was having. So you will write down, yes, he wanted to supervise Harris and George both in packing. Okay. And he wanted to teach them properly that how to do that work. So he was in that intention to behave like a supervisor. He wanted to dominate them. So you can pick up all those words that I have spoken just now. By picking up all those words, you can frame your answer. So who is going to tell me this fourth answer? What was Jerome's real intention when he offered to pack? So Divyanshi, Anju. Now these are ours, na? So what was the mistake of Raminder ma'am?
Raminder ma'am ne to sign to kar diye the, par unko strips nahi mili thi, to unhone pata nahi, unhone mere ko kya, mere ko to mere bhai ki strips milni thi na, wo kal aaya nahi tha, to usne mujhe strips de di laake.
तो बॉयज ने यहाँ से कैसे उठा ली थी? सो हु इज एट फॉल्ट सुरिंदर सर? Okay, I have got whole story. Whole of the story is based on misconception, miscommunication, wrong messages conveyed. Okay, who is going to tell me this answer? Arzu, you tell me. Aparan. He did not want. In every line you have to write down he wanted. Why are you saying he want? Bachche, 9th class, you should work on tenses.
Yes, he wanted to
write
them.
Yes,
he wanted to write them.
Yes, good. Now next question we have is, what was what did Harry say after the bag was shut and strapped? Why do you think he waited till then to ask? See, finally when the packing was done in that bag, The bag was shut. It was trapped. Okay, so what was asked by Harris to Jerem? About what thing? He required about
boots.
Yes. He had put the boots in. Okay. So it seems that it was his habit not to say a word until the job was finished. So he did not say a word until Jerem had shut and strapped the bag. It means that was a trait of his personality. That was a trait, quality, or you can say a nature, that he did not utter a single word until the work was done. Okay. So very strange, when whole of the thing was done, when whole of the packing was done, it was completely shut, it was trapped. After that, very silly question was asked, that have you put the boots in or not? So it was so strange as well as humorous, funny thing. But it could make anybody irritate. If you were in that place, how would you feel? Okay. So who is going to tell me this full-fledged answer? Only Aparan and Arzu, they will be participating. Others are on bed rest. No problem.
After a lot of hard work, Jerem packed the bags. Harris was watching him all the time, but he didn't say a word. It seems like it is his habit not to say anything until the work was done. He asked him, have you packed the boots? And that ended in his life.
Divya?
After the bag was cut and packed, he had put their boots at. It seemed his habit to say a word until the work was done. It was like his personality trait. It was really humorous, which can make others clearly irritated.
But in this answer, you have to use past tense. Okay? Each and everything should be written using past. Okay, now let's move to next question. What horrible idea occurred to Jerem a little later? Which was that horrible idea? About packing of toothbrush. Yes, that the horrible idea if he had packed his toothbrush or not. So for that, what he had to do? He had to reopen the bag and rearrange it. So it was really again, you can say sarcastic, very, you can say funny thing, that he had to reopen the bag, he had to rearrange it only to check whether toothbrushes are packed or not. So very simple answer. Who is going to tell me? Kabardur, you tell. Laksh. Nitya. Manshika. Yes. So for the sake of surety, he has to reopen and he has to check it. Where did Jerem finally find the toothbrush? Yes, inside a boot. Okay. So for which he has to take out everything and he has to shake it also. So Daljeet, you tell me full-fledged this answer. Found.
Found the toothbrush inside the boots, and he had to reopen the bag and check everything where the boots were.
Yogu, same answer.
Jerem packed the
tries to find a toothbrush, he unpacked the bag but couldn't find it. He put the thing back one by one and helped everything on my shoulder. At last, he found it inside the book.
Good. So clear? Now let's move to next question. Why did Jerem have to reopen the packed bag? To find a toothbrush. Okay, but unfortunately, what happened? But unfortunately, he had packed his? Yes, he packed his spectacles in it. So he had to reopen the bag and he had to take it out. Clear? So frame this answer. Who is going to tell me this answer? Hurry up. Pritika. Saksham. Two lines answer is there and abhi kar raha. Same students, others are taking rest. That's Jashandeep. You are always lost somewhere. And have you seen your performance in exam? This is the reason. You are lost somewhere.
After taking the toothbrush in, he had finished packing it for the board. George asked if the soap was in. He didn't care about it. But he thought he slammed the bag and strapped it. And he found that he has packed his spectacles in. So he had to go for it.
Your name is Ashmeet. Pranay, you tell me. This is not axioms. This third girl, your name is? Ramanjeet, you tell me. I'll tell you.
When she had finished the packing, thought of if the folk were in, he said, I don't care whether the folk was in or not. He slammed the bag and shut and strapped it. Then he found that he had packed his spectacles in it and he had to be open.
Okay. So Jerem packed the bag after finding his toothbrush. But unfortunately, he had packed his spectacles in it. So he had to reopen the bag to take it out. What did George and Harry offer to pack and why? So who is going to tell me the simple answer? Same students. Others, Riza, Jashan. Rane. And they have to start their journey in less than 12 hours. So there was a shortage of time also. Divyanshi. Last girl, your name is Divyanshi. Oh, Pranshi. Idhara, come here. Same answer. Lakshya, you tell me.
Tomorrow, na, you should have a hairband on your tire. Your hair from the below, stuff from the front.
Same answer. Now next question. While packing the hamper, George and Harris do a number of foolish and funny things. Pick the statement that are true. They smashed with breaking a cup. They also broke a plate. False. They squashed a tomato. They trod on the butter. They stepped on a banana. They put things behind them and couldn't. They stepped on things. True, they steps on things. It is true. They pared the picture of bottom and put heavy things on. They upset almost everything.
Yes.
They were very good at packing. Okay. Now these were very simple, short answers. You are supposed to write down these answers using 2-3 lines only. Okay. And these true false, there is no need to do in fair notebook. Only 1 to 9 you will be doing in your fair notebook. Okay. On Monday, your notebooks will be collected offline. So you do these 9 questions. Yes, on Monday I will be collecting. Because till Monday our syllabus, this chapter will be over. If there are pages, sufficient pages, you can continue with same one. If there are not sufficient pages, then purchase new one. Abhi zaruri fenkni hai. Writing skills are done there, grammar part is done there. So don't throw it. Yes. Question 1. What does Jerem say? Bacche, please let me teach. What does Jerem say was Montmorency ambition in life? So very, with lots of humor, it has been described that his day is not finished until he doesn't create disturbance and create nuisance. So such kind of lines you can copy from your literature book and add some viewpoints from your side that his ambition in life is to get in the way and get scolded. Okay. He would always be present at a place where he was not wanted. He was a perfect nuisance and make people mad. He enjoyed things thrown at his head and his day is not completed without these kind of activities. So you find out lines related to Montmorency and frame this answer. Hurry up. I would be appreciating those students who are actively participating in my class and some are sitting idle. I'm keeping them in my mind. Those who are not doing anything, you're having cold. So why have you come to school? So it's better that you go to your home. We call from reception, tell your parents to pick you up. Because I have to think about other classmates also. This can be, you can say, spread. It can spread. Huh? You just go at reception, call your parents. You are not keeping good health.
Thank you.
Very nice. Very nicely written. His highest ambition in life was to get somebody to stumble over him and curse it steadily for an hour. He was surely a nuisance. Write down these words also, that he was surely a nuisance. Okay. He created a lot of disturbance when George and Harris, they were busy in packing. Okay. He was sitting on the things which are to be packed. And where did he put his leg? He put his leg into the jam and he attacked on lemons. As thought he was, they were not lemons, they were rats. Okay. So you can pick up these lines also and frame a full-fledged long answer. Now these answers should be written in detail. You have to tell about his personality, which kind of dog he was. You have to tell about his traits, which kind of nuisance was created by him. What did he do? Which kind of problems did he do? And what was his, you can say, nature? All the things you have to mention in this answer. So Simran and Aparan, you tell afterwards. Others should be ready, those who are sitting idle and lost somewhere. Aparan.
What for Archie's ambition in life was to get in the way to be sworn at. He always shows up where he was particularly not wanted and being a perfect nuisance and made people mad and have things so instead. Then he feels his day was not wasted. I think that dog does the same what the masters do. He had some characteristics of Harris and as their master, he was funny and irritating at the same time.
Okay, good. Now listen, next question. Of the three, Jerem, George and Harris, who do you think is the best or worst packer?
Jerem was the best.
Who was worst? Who was best? So you have to pick up the points. You have to pick up all the details from where you can prove, yes, he was good and he was bad. Pick up lines from your text. You have to pick up the details from the text. From that, you can make it crystal clear. Yes, from these lines, it is crystal clear that he was good and he was worst. So you find out. Pick up these lines and frame your answer. If we take the examples of three persons, whether it is Jerome, whether it is George, or whether it is Harry's, they all proved bad to be packing. Why so? Because when Jerome seems to be a bit less worse than other, then Jerome thought that he had a knack of packing things. He was taking a pride in his skill. He was feeling so much proud that yes, he is good at this skill, okay? But still his packing skills were not good, but he was feeling pride in that. So what happened? He forgot to pack shoes, boots, okay? He himself said that he had packed toothbrush or not. So it was also told by him. And finally, when the packing task was done, he realizes that he accidentally packed his spectacles. Okay, so he had to do that work, packing, unpacking a bag a number of times. Okay, but George and Harry's, they proved to be a worse. They proved to be a worse than Jerome. Why so? Because they created a lot of mess. They broke a cup. They kept heavy things on top and light things on the bottom. They were keeping things at the behind and they couldn't find them when they were needed. They stepped on things and they upset almost all the things. So from these examples, it is crystal clear that both of these persons, they were worse in packing. So you can't say that who were good in packing. No one. No one was good in packing. Jerome was only, you can say, but he couldn't prove it. So nice question. So there are so many details given in this chapter. I have discussed with you. You pick up all these details and frame your answer. So who is going to tell me this answer? Reza or Jashan? Saksham? Vanshika? Harnoor? No response at all in class. Now it is easy to, you can say, assess 9th A class in offline mode. It is easy to assess you. See, I'm giving you one suggestion. You sit separate on that desk. You will not communicate with anybody. You will not go close to them in any of the period. Sit separate. And wear your mask also. Then you can keep it down at the time of sneezing. So, bachche, up to this question, you do it in your fair notebook. And rest of the answers we will be discussing tomorrow, and till Monday, your notebook should be complete. Do these question answers in your fair notebook.